The World Central Kitchen Charity has paused critical humanitarian operations in Gaza. An Israeli strike killed 7 of its workers.
Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu acknowledged that Israeli forces had carried out what was called an unintended strike, something the White House is calling heartbreaking and troubling. NBC's Alice Barr has the latest.
In the Gaza Strip today, tragedy, global outrage, and growing demands for answers after an Israeli airstrike killed 7 aid workers from the U.S.-based charity World Central Kitchen as they were leaving a food warehouse in clearly marked vehicles. Secretary of State Antony Blinken honoring the victims, who include a dual U.S.-Canadian citizen.
They show the best of what humanity has to offer when the going really gets tough. They have to be protected.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu acknowledging his country's forces had unintentionally hit innocent people. He's promising a full review among the dead British, Polish, and Palestinian citizens, and an experienced Australian aid worker who spoke on MSNBC last year about World Central Kitchen's mission.
We're laser focused on overcoming every obstacle.
World Central Kitchen founder Chef Jose Andres called the victims angels, adding, quote, the Israeli government needs to stop this indiscriminate killing, stop using food as a weapon. His organization, the first to bring desperately needed food into Gaza by sea, now forced to pause its operations. A spiraling crisis putting pressure on the Biden administration.
And the United States cannot continue to be complicit in the horror that is taking place there.
As the White House plays defense over its support for Israel.
That doesn't mean that it's a free pass, that we look the other way when something like this happens.
Promising to hold the Israeli government accountable for protecting aid workers and allowing supplies in to civilians on the verge of famine. In Washington, Alice Barr, NBC News.